Hey, how's it going, guys? Khan here, and today I'm back with What's in My Bag version 1. Now, I got my Canon T3i about a month or so ago. If you guys were following me on Twitter, you guys already know that. But basically, what happened was I got my camera, you know, got it, and I didn't have a bag for it. And I had actually gotten this bag about a couple months ago in July-ish, I want to say. My mom had went to yard sale, and I told her I was looking for a messenger bag, and she got me this bag. But it ended up being a little too big for my needs, so I didn't really have a use for it, right? So fast forward to, you know, last November, I got my camera in, but I didn't have a bag. And I was looking up camera bags online, and you know what? I found out that you could do it to yourself, or you could make yourself a camera bag. And this is what ended up being the product of my research. So my mom actually got this bag for $1, and I ended up making it into my camera bag, and for my needs right now, it fits absolutely perfectly. And just so you guys know, this is the primitive of primitive. Like, I only have the most necessary stuff. I don't have any cool extra stuff. But I just thought I'd make a video to show you guys. Mostly because I like this bag. I want to show you guys this bag, but I thought it was pointless to just make a video showing the bag. So I'm just going to do a What's in My Camera Bag video. Let's go ahead and take a look on the side first over here. So on the side, I have a little laser gun thing. I won this at an arcade in Atlantic City, so nothing very interesting, but I've been trying to do light paintings with it, and I've been having a lot of fun with it. So there you go, we have our little laser over there. On this side, I have a Pilot G2, my favorite, absolutely most favorite type of pen, Pilot G2. I just love writing essays. That just sounded weird, but I enjoy writing essays with pens, not pencils so much. And over here, I have a flashlight. I don't know why that's there. I think I was trying to do light painting with this, but it didn't end up very well. So let me just put that down. Oh, by the way, that's from Harbor Freight Tools. My dad got it for free because they sent some coupons, and they tend to give out flashlights for free if you buy something from there. So yeah, that's that. So out here on the left pocket is just my, I guess, cleaning kit. Not even a cleaning kit. I have a lens pen and a Spuds microfiber cloth, which I'll show you right now. So here's the microfiber cloth. Basically, you just pull it out, and then you can clean your lens with that. And then once you're done, you can just stuff it right back into its little pouch thingy here. So it's very compact and, you know, neat. It keeps it clean. And so basically, let's throw that back in there. And the lens pen basically obviously cleans the lens. There's the little brush on this side, and then over here it's the little bat thing. I don't know what that is even called, but yeah, so that's to get rid of the little stuff on top of the lens, or if your lens gets dirty, or you know, you get some stuff on your lens, that should do the job. And this was the bag that the Spuds came in, so I just put in here just to keep it nice and clean. And there you go, that's that. And over here is nothing very interesting, but I just have my charger right there. So nothing very interesting in there. And in this outer pocket here, basically what I have is my T3i manual, because as you know, this is my first DSLR ever, so I'm still learning. You know, when I'm trying to do something, I open it up and look at how I can do it. And what else do I have in here? I think the only other thing I have is the little case for the battery and an SD card. Actually, this one is the card that's usually in my Canon PowerShot, but since I used this yesterday to film some stuff at school, I ran out of space, so I threw the normal 16 gig that would usually be in here into my Canon to film this video right now. But yeah, so I usually have 4 gig on my Canon PowerShot. But today it's gonna be a 16 gig because this is full. Alright, so that's it for the outer pockets. And the main attraction of this bag is, of course, the inner pocket. So in here I have my t-shirt, actually. This t-shirt basically acts as a divider or a space holder for this end over here, so my camera doesn't move. I was going to make a divider, but then I wasn't sure if I wanted to attach it like exactly there. So I just decided, you know what, I'm just gonna throw a t-shirt in here just so, you know, it absorbs sort of some impact even if I do drop my bag. So taking my t-shirt out of there, we've got my Canon T3i in here. So you can see this is the little do-it-yourself part I was talking about. So inside it was basically empty before. I made this little carrier out of cardboard, some foam, and tape. And, well, of course, this fabric here. So let me grab my camera, Canon T3i. So there you go. This is my camera right here. 18 to 55 millimeter lens, just the kit lens. I don't have any cool, awesome lenses right now, but I hopefully will sometime in the future. So there you go, just my Canon T3i. So I'll place that over to the side. I'll show you guys the bag. So here it is. You can see I have a little step right there. This step was meant to hold up the side of the lens when I lay it sideways. So that was kind of that. So you can see I just hastily threw it together, but if you look from the top, you can't even notice that bottom part. So I just stick that in there to basically support the weight of the lens. So basically you can see if I put it in like this, it's not wobbling down towards the lens. So it basically keeps my camera still from, you know, just sliding sideways and backwards and whatnot. So you can see here, and basically I couldn't make it into a full box because it wouldn't have fit in the bag because of the zipper otherwise. So basically I kept it as a normal piece, and then once I got it in there, I just put it in place, and the bag shape actually holds it in place. So, I mean, I used an Amazon box to cut out the layout of this bag, and it ended up actually looking really nice. I like the color too, the green color. My mom actually got this fabric from a yard sale also for my green screen because she didn't know that a green screen had to be like a lime green. She got me this and I didn't use it, and you know what? It ended up being very useful for my do-it-yourself camera bag. So I mean, I made this off of instructions. Initially, the blog post I read used, you know, a sewing machine and all that stuff, but I thought, you know what? A sewing machine, I don't feel like sewing. I mean, I enjoyed sewing a couple years ago, but that was kind of a phase. And I mean, I didn't have time to really sew. So I just used tape, and it ended up really just as nice, in my opinion. So yeah, that's my do-it-yourself camera bag. So yeah, that's my camera bag. So basically, when I load it up, I just do this. Load that in there, and, you know, put my t-shirt in, and that was just the flashlight. Stuff my t-shirt in to keep it from, you know, flying all over the place. Stuff that strap in there. Zip it up, and I'm basically ready to go. And if you guys want to see the strap, here's the strap. It does have a nice shoulder strap. So, yeah. And if you guys want to know what the brand of this bag is, I'm going to have to tell you I have no idea. Absolutely no idea. I'm pretty sure it's just like a nameless brand thing. Yeah, it works out really well. It's a really nice bag. I mean, I'll post a link to the carrier instructions for the little carrier box thing that I made for this bag, so you guys can basically follow that to make it for your own messenger bag if you would so like. By the way, guys, if you guys are photographers, Flickr is actually giving away 3 months of Flickr Pro for free for this holiday season. I just activated it on my account this morning, so my Flickr account is now a pro account, which I'll have a link to down below. And basically you get a pro account for 3 months, and then once the 3 months up, you go back to a normal free account. But basically the pro account gives you basically unlimited uploads, so that's really awesome. Of course, I'm not being sponsored by Flickr or anything, but I thought it was a really great deal. And since, you know, this video is about my camera bag and whatnot, I thought it was really relevant and thought I'd let you know. So I'll have a link to my Flickr and the link to the Flickr 3 months pro down below if you guys would like to take advantage of that. So yeah. Alright guys, so that's it for my what's in my camera bag video version 1. Hopefully I'll have a version 2 coming soon, maybe no longer than a year. So yeah, I'll do another what's in my bag if I get a couple more upgrades, you know, maybe a lens, a new bag, or whatnot, or anything that is actually a major upgrade that I think you guys would enjoy seeing. So of course today is December 22nd, so happy the world didn't end yesterday day. And of course, happy holidays to you guys, and hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I will see you all next time.